and I love to move, which is why my hip-hop dance class is one of my favorite places on Earth. Ouch, cramp time.
Whoa, cool. I wonder what move that is.
The move might be cool, but her running out of class again isn't. What's up with her?
Can't stop. Urgently need the bathroom! Ugh, it's like my ulcerative colitis knows when I'm having fun and chooses then to act up. And the worst part is, my friends are starting to notice. How do I explain things to them when I don't even?
Welcome to Medi Kids HQ, Amy.
Get it? Gastro? Abacus? What am I doing here?
Ooh, that's a big question. I mean, really, what are any of us doing here, you know?
No, I mean, like, what am I doing here?
Oh, that's easy. You're here to learn about your ulcerative colitis. Ulcerative colitis is a condition that affects your digestive system, also known as your gut. Let's start with the stomach. Abacus, initiate teleporter to Mediland.
What's Mediland?
Mediland is a planet that works and looks just like the human body. Stand by for teleportation.
In the stomach.
This is where food comes to get broken down. Cool, huh?
A, this is super cool. B, I super don't want to get broken down too.
This unit agrees with Amy.
Fine, fine. Sheesh, a guy can't even enjoy the majestic beauty of food getting mushed anymore. Follow me.
Where are we going?
We're following the food. After it gets mashed up, it heads to your small and large bowels.
The small bowel.
Welcome to the small bowel.
What happens here?
See for yourself. Your small bowel's main job is to take nutrients from your food. Your body needs nutrients to work properly and to grow.
Hey, where's the food going?
After all the good stuff is taken out, your food moves into the large bowel. Come on!
In the large bowel.
Who are those guys and what are they doing with the food mush?
Those are large bowel cells. Their job is to squeeze all the water out of your food.
Once that's done, everything that's left is squished together to make your poop. Look at the size of that one. Isn't she a beauty?
Gastro, you and I have very different definitions of beauty.
The muscle walls then move your poop towards your bottom.
Knowing how poop is made is cool and stuff, but what does this have to do with my colitis?
The large bowel is the part of your gut that gets damaged when you have ulcerative colitis, or UC.
Yup, what Abacus said.
Wait, damaged? How?
Well, it all starts with these guys. Amy, meet the white blood cells. They are part of your immune system.
Move it, germ.
Note, the immune system usually protects you from infections by fighting germs and other harmful invaders.
Okay, but that sounds like a good thing. How does that cause UC?
In ulcerative colitis, the immune system mistakes your gut for germs.
Hey, you see what I see?
I don't know. What do you see?
Germs! They're everywhere! Get them!
Attack!
The immune system starts to see your gut as germs and attacks it. This causes inflammation in your gut, which makes it sore, red, and swollen.
I can see that! I can also see my dance training has become survival training!
Small sores called ulcers can develop on the walls that line the large bowel. Sometimes these ulcers bleed or make pus.
That sounds a little gross and majorly uncomfortable.
You said it! And all these sores cause symptoms, which are clues that tell doctors what is happening inside your body. One symptom is diarrhea. It happens because the gut can't absorb water, so the water stays in your poop and makes it runny. Your poop might even have blood, mucus, or pus in it if there is a lot of damage in your gut. Diarrhea can cause cramps that can make going to the toilet painful, and the discomfort makes people run to the bathroom. With ulcerative colitis, you might need to go to the bathroom a lot.
I think we might need to go anywhere else.
Calculations complete. there is a 100% chance of getting zapped if we stay.
I could have told you that.
Come on, let's regroup.
Who knew ulcerative colitis could cause so much trouble?
Yeah, it can also make you feel sick and not want to eat. If you aren't eating well, this can make you feel tired. Losing blood can make you feel tired too.
Ah! The white blood cells are here and they're yawning? What gives? Why aren't they attacking?
Relax. Ulcerative colitis is only bad when you have a flare-up. It's not all the time. There's going to be times when your symptoms don't even bother you.
Note, when you don't have any symptoms, it is called remission.
Hey, things are looking better.
Yeah, remission gives your body time to heal. But remember, just as there are remissions, there are also...
Attack!
Flare-ups or relapses when your symptoms become active and cause problems again. Flare-ups can happen a few times or lots of times.
Already?
Sometimes, flare-ups can be triggered by a gut infection or feeling stress.
But often, flare-ups happen on their own without any triggers. Honestly, it's kind of different for everybody.
Okay, I get it, but what can I do about it?
There's no cure for ulcerative colitis just yet, but there are treatments. Treatment can help reduce your symptoms. Some treatments reduce the number of flare-ups and help keep you in remission.
Whoa, sweet!
Treatments are usually given as pills, liquids, or infusions.
What do they do?
Grab one and I'll show you.
Infusion means giving small, continuous amounts of medicine directly into the bloodstream.
Whoa, things are even worse than before.
Let's not waste any time. Medicine away!
It worked! They stopped fighting!
Yeah, medicine can help reduce the immune system attacks so the gut is less red, sore, and swollen. This helps reduce symptoms and also helps stop flare-ups from happening.
Does anyone else have the sudden urge to hug?
I do!
Because each medicine works differently, your doctor will decide which one is best for you. Be sure to take your medicine exactly the way the doctor tells you.
Sometimes surgery is the best option when flare-ups are serious and happen very frequently.
Mediland's colon is in remission for now. Good work, team! Let's head back to HQ.
Okay, so now I get what ulcerative colitis is, but why did I get it in the first place?
Great question. Unfortunately, we don't know. The only thing we know for sure is that you're more likely to get it if someone else in your family has it too. But don't worry, there's lots you can do to help keep your symptoms under control. Along with taking your medicine, stuff like eating healthily, drinking plenty of water, keeping a food diary, and exercising can also help.
Yeah, and that's all great, but no matter what, I still have ulcerative colitis, you know?
I know, and I know that living with it can be hard. But you aren't alone, and if you ever feel worried or sad, don't be scared to talk to your parents, teachers, or doctor. They're all there for you.
Thanks, Gastro. I feel a lot better now that I know what's up with my UC. But I should probably be getting back. This is like the longest bathroom break ever.
No problem. But before you go, I want to give you this. It's a Medicron. A wrist computer just like mine. Now you can teach people about ulcerative colitis as an honorary Medikid.
Awesome. Thanks, Gastro. Thanks, Abacus.
Bye, Amy.
Goodbye, organic being designated as Amy.
Back on Earth.
Gotta get back to class.
Amy, there you are. We were worried when you disappeared.
Sorry. Look, I know I tend to disappear a lot, but if you give me a second, I can explain everything. See, I have this thing called ulcerative colitis. Are you okay?
Whoa!
What does that mean?
I had no idea.
Ulcerative colitis is a condition that affects your digestive system, also known as your gut.
Gastro, are you in need of medical attention?
What? No! I'm dancing!
Scan indicates that is not dancing.